air, followed by a ferocious shriek and rushing wing pushed by a blue drake's wings as they used their spellcraft to entice the dragon from wherever its lair was. Draconic magic could entice nearby dragons or even recall them to Esfa from whatever plane they went to after they perished here, but they could not control the beasts. The morel in the distance panicked and scattered, abandoning the framework of the tower they constructed. Roaring, the creature sucked in a lungful of air and spat its elemental breath in an arcing line. It blasted the frenzied scouts like a hot stream of piss on a line of ants, only far deadlier. The beast screeched victoriously and flapped its scaly wings, circling around to locate its kill, the remaining few stragglers who escaped. Lucius grabbed a nearby scout and pointed to the spellcasters. "Run up the rise and tell Chiamna to send the drake onward now so we can advance safely. Have them stay put until we send for them. I want to make sure it's safe that we won't need to double back before we expose the Quitain. Morel have been known to lay traps before." The runner nodded and then dashed up the hill to relay her queen's orders. As soon as the notice was given and the dragon began shrinking towards the distance, a warhorn's peal split the air from atop the lookout post. A lone morel survivor blew the trumpet and continued blasting it from the uppermost level of the partially completed structure. Lucius grimaced and snapped her rein. "I must have miscounted by one." She and her warriors hid their mounts and sped towards the lookout post. They had to shut him up as soon as possible. Conflict was inevitable.